we are flying a green algae, which people think of as pump scum, which it is, but there's much more to it.
They are a great little tiny traveling companion that can answer a lot of our needs.
Green algae are a very special entrance point, a key to studying cells and their reactions in the whole plant world.
Algae is a wonderful source of hydrogen, which is a gas but that can be used as a fuel. You can eat algae. You may have to do a little something to make them tasty, but they are edible. When you go into deeper space, and Artemis is going to go a lot further than, let's say, the International Space Station, it's going to be exposed to what we call deep space radiation, which is more intense and a somewhat different kind of radiation than we can generate here on the surface of the Earth. We have thousands of different kinds of algae. Each one is missing one little key part of its total machinery, its total information. We're going to let them grow as they go around the moon, and we're going to see who grows the fastest and the best, because that's the one that you want to take with you when you go to Mars.
Our work will begin to answer the questions of how to optimize plants in space and how to protect astronauts in space. Space is a very good tool to answer clinical questions on the ground. We've never had the chance to study cosmic radiation since the 70s, and the tools to do it now are dramatically better. So Artemis will let us learn a lot of things that are both relevant to radiation therapy on the ground and protecting astronauts for long-term flight based on which genes are responsive to the radiation.
I'm Holly Birdsall.
And I'm Tim Hammond.
And we are Artemis.